precious cargo just arrived at the airport in Springerville, Arizona.
Wow, they look real wiggly.
Endangered Mexican wolf pups, four of them from the California Wolf Center in Julian, California.
Our veterinarians here will do a quick check on those guys, make sure that, you know, they're warm enough, that they're hydrated, that they're all looking good, healthy, squirmy little puppies. That's what we want to see.
These six-day-old pups were born in captivity, but starting today, they'll be raised in the wild.
I'll just give a teeny bit.
Two of them are going to New Mexico. The other two will stay in the White Mountains of Arizona. They'll be placed with the Panther Creek Wolf Pack through a process called cross-fostering.
This is a captive-to-wild cross-foster effort. So you're taking neonatal wolf pups born in captivity and introducing them into a litter of wild wolves born in the wild. Right now, the captive population has a higher level of genetic diversity than does the wild population. So what we hope is to introduce genetics that are novel to the wild population into a wild litter, and these pups will grow up to adulthood and actually survive and reproduce.
That's important because the Mexican wolf gene pool is not very deep. At the end of 2016, there was a minimum of 113 Mexican wolves in the wild in Arizona and New Mexico. That entire experimental population can be traced to just seven wolves that were the foundation of a captive breeding program started in 1977. That's why these little pups are a pretty big deal.
In order for cross-fostering to work, you have to have the birth dates or whelp dates of the captive wolves and the wild wolves match up very closely. So these animals have to be under 14 days of age, and they have to be, the donor litter and the recipient litter have to be within 6 to 8 days of each other for us to have the highest level of success.
In this case, the captive-born pups are 6 days old, and the wild pups are thought to be about 13 days old. It's an educated guess based on the behavior of Panther Creek's breeding female.
She looks good, you guys.
She's known as Alpha Female 1339. Biologists with the Mexican Wolf Interagency Field Team captured her in January and fitted her with a new GPS radio collar, which lets them track her movements.
Since the beginning of April, we've been watching all of our female wolves very closely that are collared, in the hopes of determining when they start to localize in an area and when they exhibit denning behavior. So denning behavior is really just localizing in a specific area, sticking tight to that area. We feel confident that the Panther Creek female is denning and that she has her own litter of wild pups.
About the time the pups had reached the airport, wolf biologist Ed Davis was out searching for the den.
We walked in, me and Craig went in first. We went to where a cluster of our GPS points were already. We didn't quite see a den just right there, so we just kind of kept searching the area. While we were doing that, we saw the female kind of cross the draw and take off on the other side of the hill, so we knew we were close. We kind of just kept hooking around the side there, and then we eventually saw a little bit of dirt movement, and so that usually means a den's close by. So we kind of crept up to the side. We could see pups in there.
After setting up a processing station, biologists remove the wild pups from their den. Then, with assembly line efficiency, each pup is processed.
This is going to be Panther Creek A.
It involves putting a microchip in each pup so that we can identify them later on when we trap and collar them.
Pit tag in there.
Taking blood for each pup to have genetics on file.
And then did we get a temp on this little guy yet?
97.
Okay. Did you check the rooting or suckling on this little guy at all? So let's go ahead and do this cheek swab. We'll do a cheek swab on this one.
We'll take organic material from the den, like hair, dirt, that kind of thing, rub it all over every pup so they smell the same.
Well, let's pull them out one at a time, make them pee on each other.
We'll stimulate them to urinate and defecate on each other so that they smell all the same in that way.
Everyone grab a pup. Group pee.
If any of them have been fed or been feeding, we'll put milk on each of their mouths so they're all the same.
All right.
Once that alpha female, that mother female, returns to the den, she'll just have a litter waiting there. And the beauty of this is that wolves can't count. And so Ideally, she will accept those guys, and we've seen a very high level of success with this in the past.
Last little guy on the writing and everything.
Everything's good.
Okay.
Cross-fostering has proven successful with red wolves back east. It was first attempted with Mexican wolves in 2014 when two pups from a wild litter in Arizona were placed into a wild litter in New Mexico. They both survived and formed packs of their own. And it didn't take long before the cross-fostered female had her own litter of pups. 2016 was the first year captive-born Mexican wolf pups were cross-fostered into wild wolf dens. By the end of the year, biologists had encountered at least two of the six cross-fostered pups. One of them was captured and collared.
This is incredibly important. This right now is the way that we have gone with to introduce genetics novel to the wild wolf population into the wild.
The alternative is to release captive adult wolves, but they tend to be habituated to humans, which may lead to nuisance behaviors.
I think we got everything done, but let's go double check.
Biologists expect to see less of that from wolves that were cross-fostered as pups.
These wolves will be raised wild from the second they enter that wild wolf den. They learn how to be wolves from a wild mother who grew up in the wild herself, knows how to hunt, and receives very little exposure to people.
Time will tell us more about the long-term success of cross-fostering Mexican wolves, but for now, it's an important new management tool that's producing positive results.
Yeah, this is very new. This is a completely new aspect of Mexican wolf recovery, and we're so excited to pioneer this effort.
That was about as good as you could hope for. That was really good.
What's even better is the fact that radio signals indicate that the mother wolf returned to the den shortly after the cross-foster operation had concluded.